What did you enjoy about revisiting this character and playing Dr. Julia once again? What do you love about it the most? Or enjoy about it the most?
I have to say, I just love her in general. I think she's quite snazzy. and I loved just putting on her wardrobe, and I loved her wig and
her
accessories, which only one person really was aware of what my lovely necklace really was. Mr. Jason Sudeikis gives you a little insight into his personal life.
I love
life.
Catalogs. I just love catalogs. Looking into I bend the pages, you know, the corners if there's something that I like, and you know, that's all.
What is your horrible job that you had before you start working on television and cinema? Mm. Your horrible job.
Let's get it out of the way right up front.
Yeah.
I was a telemarketing.
In which company? What did you do?
I was trying to sell timeshares in the Poconos. And I say trying.
Yeah.
I didn't actually ever sell one.
I was never good at sales either. I had a few jobs like retail, like working at Banana Republic, and I could
see,
never.
See, that would have been fun, where you take the little cardboard thing and you might fold the T-shirts.
I don't need it. I don't even need it. I can do it.
You just freehanded it?
Yeah. It looks great. No, it was the selling. It was like upselling. You know? Yeah, trying to improve my UPTs, units per transaction. I just couldn't do it.
Couldn't do it. With this charm and that face.
That's very sweet of you. Wait, are you being sarcastic?
No, I'm being 100% honest.
I didn't give a damn.
I would just laugh my way and just be like, you are so cute. That striped shirt, yeah. I'm going to take that little banana.
I wish you would have come through Banana Republic on Michigan Avenue.
Yeah, I wasn't there.
Yeah.
And that's all we have time for.
We have time for one more question.
Thank you.
That's it.
It is a luxury, actually, to be friends with these people and love and adore them on a personal level, and then to be able to have worked together, separately together, and together, it's kind of a dream job. Jason called it a movie camp.
It is. It's like movie camp. Yeah, on the plane here. I was
on
like,
the
isn't
plane,
this fun?
And we saw Benedict Cumberbatch.
Yeah. Yeah.
And we all descended upon him.
Yeah.
And I think he signed up for the third.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. The new boss.
Yeah. Horrible Bosses 3. He's the new boss. That's announced. I'm announcing that here.
Yeah. There you go.
You got
someone
it.
Should let him know. You'll let him know.
Well,
yeah.
Someone will.
There's an illuminating scene in the credits where you say, I can't deliver that line.
Yeah.
And I just wondered.
What was it?
Well, you don't deliver it. So
no, I don't. I actually can't remember what the line was, but I have been reminded by somebody that it had to do with gravy and an undercarriage.
Well, I wondered what the line.
That's right. I don't know what that means.
Yeah.
And I just went, ooh.
Yeah.
It's a holiday meal.
Yeah.
It's not. I don't think gravy's funny in sexual.
No, that's why it's not in the movie.
Yeah, we got rid of it. Didn't test well.
But I wondered what line you had actually delivered that made you squirm the most, and whether this is a sign that this character is as far away from the real you as you've ever got.
Well, in language, yes, I would say. I mean, you know. Suck it like a bomb. What is it?
Bomb pop.
Suck it like a bomb pop down to the blue is not something that normally comes sort of tripping off of my tongue.
That should be a Nicki Minaj song, though. That's like you put a beat under that.
That's so true.
Yeah. These little girls will be dancing to it, like, you know, just like in the car. Daddy, put on Suck It Like a Bomb Pop. And then in parentheses, down to the blue.
We seem to be in the midst of another wave of feminism at the moment, and as a woman who is...
Are we in another wave of it?
Another wave, yeah.
There was a third.
Get your trunks on.
Why?
Anyone got any wings?
As a woman who's spoken out about feminist issues and a woman working in an industry that's been criticised as being sexist, I wondered what changes you've seen, both positive and negative, for women in your career.
Well, I think one positive is that there have been many more movies with female leads and ensembles, and those movies are doing really well. So I think that's fantastic. I think... for me personally, I loved that Dr. Julia was sort of taking the role of what would normally be a male character in a film.
You mean a dentist?
Yeah. Yeah. You don't see a lot of female dentists,
yeah.
Do you?
I guess you don't.
Yeah. But I think it's good. But it is, there still is sexism. It just sort of exists. Double standards, all that stuff.
Jennifer, I have to tell you that I adore you.
Thank you.
I am a big fan of you. I've seen all your movies. I think that you are great actress, not just in the comedy. I see the drama. You are fantastic.
Thank you.
I'm in love with you. Seriously.
Oh, I love you too. We should meet after this.
Can we get out of here?
I feel like we need to be left alone.
Yeah.
Box of tissues, please, before you go on this side.
Yes, yeah, very good question for you as well. How difficult is it to be in the role of a woman which is completely obsessed with sex?
How is it to be in at Mike? I mean, the woman who is obsessed with sex. I think it's hysterical, and I find it quite amusing because I don't think to her there's anything wrong or deviant about herself. I think she actually is describes sex and approaches sex as though a chef approaches a wonderful meal to be made, or you know. I think it's kind of just very commonplace for her. And it's like a sport. I think it's fantastic.
And the other question was what kind of bossies are you all?
Great.
Great boss. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, fair.
Fair. There we go.
Fair.
We got nice. Jeff in the second row there, please. We get a microphone to... If we do the one closest with the moustache... Mr. Moustache, Mrs. Movember, you go first, and then the one
the fuller
end.
Moustache.
Here we go.
Where Thank you very much, which actually is my question.
Oh, that's just dirt.
First of all, sports a fabulous moustache in the movie. Apart from Charlie, obviously, you got the full beard. Yeah. Were you tempted to grow moustaches yourselves? Jen, you can answer that question as well.
I missed this entire question. I just heard a moustache, and then I just noticed Charlie.
The question was, were you tempted to grow a moustache?
Was I?
Film?
Yeah. I already have
just
a
just like Christoph's in the movie.
No. I've worn a mustache at times in my life. Our first movie together, I had one. Yeah,
you did. That's
our first movie together. Too.
You had a mustache. A very healthy one.
Did you shoot those at the same time?
Mm-hmm, yeah. Same mustache too.
Same mustache.
Yeah,
yeah. We started the movie with the same mustache.
How about that?
That's right, yeah.
Six
yeah.
degrees of my mustache.
Did you feel men reacted differently towards you when you were wearing this dark brown wig?
What, these guys? No.
Other men.
Men in general.
Men in general. Well, no, on set, there was, I think, that it kind of got old after the first day. It was pretty.
And then you washed it.
And then I washed it. Yep. And then, yeah. It was, everyone knew it was a character, but I don't think anyone really. I think people watching it felt differently about just seeing that visual was just fun for people, but I didn't get treated any different. I'm still like, yeah.
My question is, what is your personal dream, something that you want to achieve in your private life and a professional dream? By the way, my private dream is to have a selfie with Jennifer.
Oh.
Yeah.
That's a private dream.
Yeah. Maybe you can help me later. I
think dreams can come true.
Let's see.
Okay. Or they
Sometimes
could turn into
nice
nightmares.
To let dreams remain dreams.
So what is your professional dream and your personal dream and my selfie later?
Yeah,
I'm going to take world peace and throw it to
For
you guys.
For personal or professional? Oh, wow.
I'm going to second that. I think that's a great dream. Don't we all have that dream?
I think that's a universal dream you all have.
Yeah.
Jen, how do you find it being kind of the only lady? Like, do you see yourself as one of the lads? Does it get quite laddie? And
well, you know? I'm sadly left out of there. This is the most fun I'm having because I get to be with the guys. They have each other, and I'm sort of left on my own in the room. But I mean, I get more one-on-one time with everyone, so I guess that's
with you, nice folks. Yeah. Let her finish.
No. but I do. I mean, these are fun, especially when you love the movie so much and you love the cast that you get to play with and hang out with and fly with, and we just have a great time. Yeah. I don't feel like one of the lads, though. I do feel like I still feel like a lady. I don't have a nickname.
Yeah.
Do I?
No. Oh. Jen.
Jen.
Jen is
it.
A name.
But that's
yeah.
just a half, that's like a shortening of my name.
Yeah.
Not a nickname. Oh, although in high school I was
Uh-oh.
Come on. Uh-oh. You've started, so you'll finish. Come on.
Oh, boy.
It's not going to happen.
No.
Come on.
It's quite embarrassing. Well, there was a lot of Jennifers in my grade, so we all had different names.
So?
I was Jenna Bean.
Oh.
And then I was Joe Jen.
It's not so bad.
Those aren't bad.
No, it's just not impressive.
What did the B stand for?
Huh?
What did the B stand? You say Jen B?
Jenna Bean.
Oh, Jenna Bean. Oh, gotcha.
What did the Joe stand for?
Yeah.
My middle name is Joanna.
Got it.
There it is.
So you had a dyslexic class.
Joe Jen.
Joe Jen.
This is one of the first times you've had a chance to revisit a character, and it's obviously been a wonderful comedic reunion with the boys, but I think the one comedic reunion we're all very curious about is Friends, and whether or not that would ever be something that you'd be interested in.
Are you going to do a Friends 2?
Friend harder.
This Still is friends? The new cast right yeah, here. These are your friends.
Who do I get to be?
You get to be Chandler.
Nice. And Jason?
You get to be Joey. Oh, that means you'd be Ross.
Hey-o.
Nice. Yes, I like that.
Yeah.
That'd be good. Woo. I've never seen the show. What are you referring to?
And there's Kudrow down at the end.
Yeah, there you go.
Oh, then, yes. I don't know. Yeah. I don't think I'll that. Honestly, I think we should wait until we're really old and then maybe reunite.
Senior friends.
Yeah, golden friends.
Golden friends.
Golden
there you
friends.
Go.
That could have a completely different
That's
meaning.
Right. That's yeah. right. They pee on each other.
Well, Charlie, we got
there
it.
Go.
I just wanted to spell it
okay,
out.
I think we should end this now.